You don't analyze your campaigns after 6 months and then you have a big report and then you react. Mobile is about today. It is about using your data quickly in real time and then optimize on the go. And that's something where mobile makes a big difference. If you just look at communications, of course our media strategy is hugely influenced by mobile. What we normally do is that we talk to our media agency, then set up a media strategy. And what I'm then also doing is use media audits in order to see how are the different channels performing and how do they achieve the goals I set up. And one thing is pretty clear, if you look at the numbers of the last years, mobile is increasing significantly because customer behavior changed and we're using more of our media money to put it on mobile. Today it is very important also for insurance companies not to delegate customer service and experience only to intermediates, but to be pretty clear what you as a company want to do and serve the customers. We always start with customer first and then look at the technology. And I'm a big believer in so-called customer journeys and digital customer journeys to say where are the pain points, where do we have to use different techniques, and how do we then answer to customer needs. I mean, for instance, you could use chatbots today in order to answer questions quicker than you can do with humans because chatbots can be deployed 24/7. Or we are also using augmented reality in order to make an experience which is more sexy, so to speak. Yeah? And we are using AI technologies in order to be quicker in answer to some customer needs. So technology is very important, but first ask yourself, what kind of customer need do I want to cater against? In total, I always measure successes of my campaigns and try to look at it as a whole. I don't believe in silos and just looking at mobile. I think you have to look at the campaign in total and then check what kind of channel performed best and then have learnings for the future in order to deploy better in the future. If you look at mobile campaigns, I don't believe that you can look at them in isolation. I'm a big believer in looking at campaigns as a whole and then should try to find out which channel performed best and how to best deploy in the future. One of the key challenges today is, of course, to look at the data and combine everything. Because we don't have good tools yet that combine TV, the traditional channels with the digital channels, and then you cannot always answer what kind of information or action triggered customer response or even purchase. So that's something you have to find out over time and then optimize your data. Today's consumers don't have the patience anymore to wait 2 weeks for a policy or 4 months for a claim. And let us go to the extreme. So today you have to be quicker in responding to your customers. And everybody's using Amazon, for example. Yeah? With Amazon, you go to the website, you click a button, you get what you want. And the insurance industry has to adapt and we have to do the same thing. So what we're doing today is looking at how can we speed up certain processes, how can we become quicker. And we have one example which we always quote and also our chairman quotes, which is the AI example where we went from 58 minutes for reading medical reports to 5 seconds, huge difference. And that also means we can respond to customers much quicker in order to give them an answer if their claims is granted, yes or no. Today, I mean, everybody talks about getting feedback from customers and understanding what they want. So what you have to do is A, define what is your target customer, and then really understand what they want. We are using NPS, Net Promoter Score service, globally for everybody, for all the countries, since 2013. So that's one of our cornerstones. And that we complement with market research and real-time feedback and analysis in the countries as well, So I think that you need a global framework, but then also be very agile and quick in the countries in order to understand what your customer needs in the markets on the ground. Because we are a global company and I'm responsible on a global basis, you can say each countries and each industries are different. So there are differences between commercial lines and private lines, the differences between life insurances and GI insurances. So you really have to understand which business are you looking at and then tailor your communication towards the needs of the industry you're looking at and the clients you're looking at. Very important. And then you have to find solutions to cater against it. What we have learned in optimizing strategies for mobile is that you have to always use data, learn from your data, learn of about what worked well, didn't work that well, and then optimize. And the difference between mobile and television, for instance, is that you don't analyze your campaigns after 6 months and then you have a big report and then you react. I mean, mobile is about today, it is about using your data quickly in real time and then optimize on the go. And that's something where mobile makes a big difference. Content specifically for mobile channels, I don't believe in, to be honest. Because you need storytelling today. It's not about just sending out information. You need stories around your brand. And then ideally, you get customers to react to your stories as well and get them engaged. One of the topics we're looking at, for instance, is protection gap. Yeah? So how do you get people engaged to say, how do I take care of my future? How do I best invest my money? How can we help? And that's something where we get people engaged in. Mobile helps, though, to be very specific in your content, because we have a tendency in the industry to be very complex and very complicated in our communication. Mobile forces you to be focused and have short text and short messages, which I think is very helpful because it helps me to get people focused on the main content and not be too complicated in our messaging.